Hello viewers, do you suspect the MAF sensor in your car is bad? Maybe its engine is running rough and it's down on power, or you've noticed the gas mileage is down. Well, before jumping to conclusions and hastily replacing it, you should first check and test it, and in this video, I'll show you how. The MAF sensor can be tested using several methods, one of which is to simply unplug it while the car is running. If the sensor is good, the engine should start running rougher or even cut out, because the ECU doesn't know how much air is getting in and can't adjust the mixture correctly. But if there is no change whatsoever, there is a good chance the MAF sensor is broken and the ECU doesn't rely on its readings at all. Still, this rudimentary method isn't the most precise, and to get a better insight, you'll need an OBD scanner. And this doesn't need to be an expensive device, as even the cheapest, simplest ones will do the trick here. Start by connecting it and checking the error codes. Sometimes the ECU will notice something's off with the MAF readings, trigger a check engine light, and store a code, which, in case of a bad MAF sensor, would be one of these. But even if there is a code indicating an issue with the MAF sensor, I wouldn't rush to replace it just yet. The thing is, other engine problems, such as intake leaks, especially on turbocharged cars, can mess up the readings, which the ECU then sees as a faulty MAF sensor. Instead, my advice is to carry out several more tests to determine the source of the problem. One of them is to use the scan tool again to access live data, from where you can observe the actual MAF sensor readings it sends to the ECU. So, with the engine not running, this should say 0 grams per second because, well, there is no airflow. Anything else indicates a MAF related issue, the sensor itself or the wiring. Now turn on the engine and wait for a couple of seconds until it achieves a steady idle speed, say approximately 700 RPM. At this point, the MAF readings should be somewhere between 2 and 6 or 7 grams per second, depending on the engine's displacement. Obviously, the figure for a small 4-cylinder engine will be much lower than it would be for a big V8. Still, it would be ideal to have a chart or table with correct MAF readings for your car, as this will make the analysis more accurate. The next step is to see how the MAF sensor reacts to changes in engine speed. For this, you'll need to monitor the MAF readings and the RPM at the same time, again, in the live data section of your diagnostic tool. So what you do is, press the throttle slightly and rev up the engine to approximately 3000 RPM, and while the engine speed is going up, pay attention to what the MAF sensor is saying. Basically, these two values should go up and down at the same rate. If, for instance, you see the MAF readings are lagging, not going up as fast as the engine speed, the MAF sensor is not functioning correctly. There's also a trick mechanics use called a snap test. What you do here is, again, monitor the MAF readings in the live data. With the engine warmed up and idling, press the throttle fully for a brief moment, half a second or a second. This obviously will cause the engine to rev up very fast and then go back to idle after a second or two. And during this time, the MAF readings should follow accordingly. And if the diagnostic tool is set to show them in a form of a graph, you'll see this as a spike, like here. But if the MAF sensor is faulty or just dirty, it won't be able to react to this sudden change, and these values won't go up as they should. Or in other words, that spike will be much lower, or you might not even see it at all. And this is something that will probably cause drivability issues, especially on hard accelerations, when the ECU won't be able to correctly adjust the air-fuel mixture. One more thing you can do with the scan tool is have a helper wiggle the MAF sensor's wiring while you monitor its readings. This is best done with the engine on and idling at a steady speed. If you see any sudden changes in the MAF readings during this procedure, it's almost certain there is a wiring issue. A damaged wire, loose or corroded connector, and so on. And you'll want to inspect that area more closely. Apart from the scan tool, you can also use an ordinary multimeter to check the MAF sensor's resistance and voltage. Let's start with the resistance, for which you'll need to set the multimeter's knob to ohm readings. Next, unplug the wiring connector, place the probes on the sensor pins, and check the resistance. This is easy to do on cars that have two pin MAF sensors, where one is ground and the other is signal voltage to the ECU. But when it's something like this, with 4 or 5 pins, you'll probably need a wiring diagram to identify which of them is which. The correct values differ depending on the model, but some usual numbers range between 2 and 4 ohms, so if you see something close to 0 or very high, it's likely that the sensor is bad. And, as I said, the voltage readings. They will reveal how many volts the MAF sensor is sending back to the ECU. To check this, you'll need to set the multimeter to volts, back probe it into the sensor's connector, and check the voltage in different situations, with the engine off, while idling, and at 2 or 3000 RPM. If the values are out of range for that specific model, the MAF sensor is bad. On the other hand, if they seem to be okay, but differ from those you can see on your scan tool, it's quite likely there is a wiring issue. Now, these were the ways to test the MAF sensor, and if they reveal it's not giving correct values, what you can do before replacement is try to clean it. This is especially true if its readings are just slightly off. The thing is, if this hot wire inside the MAF sensor is covered with dust or oil, it'll take a bit more time for it to react to changes in airflow. And then you have those situations where the sensor's readings can't keep up when you rev up the engine sharply. The good news is, cleaning a dirty MAF sensor is a simple job you can easily do on your own. Just undo the wiring connector, undo the bolts or clips that may be holding it in place, and remove it from the engine bay. Then put it on a work table or a similar suitable surface, take a can of MAF cleaner and spray the sensor from the inside, concentrating on the hot wire element. Still make sure not to touch the wire with anything, as these are super fragile. And you don't need to empty a whole can. A few short bursts will do the trick. Once the sensor is all nice and clean, let it dry for a few minutes before fitting it back. And that's the MAF sensor cleaning completed. If you're lucky, this will solve your engine running issues, and if not, you'll probably have to buy a new one. So there you have it, viewers. Those would be the ways to test the MAF sensor, as well as how to clean it if this proves to be necessary. I hope this video was helpful, and if so, don't forget to hit that like button and share it with your friends. On the other hand, if you're having some different issues with your car, be sure to check other videos here or visit our site, mechanicbase.com, for detailed automotive repair guides. Bye!